house with him. How do you get invited
to the party?
Yeah.
Well, the girl, Melanie, my nose is still fucked up.
Well, do you do a lot of coke, or are you just saying you don't because,
No, I don't, because I actually have anxiety. I have anxiety disorder. Thanks. It's just a messed up from that night. I can't do it because I have anxiety disorder. That's why I have Xanax in the first place.
Right.
So the whole time I was at Charlie's house, I'm sitting there and he's blowing, smoke into my mouth, smoking the cocaine, blowing into my mouth. I'm sitting there like taking Xanax pieces. I'm like, oh my God. Oh, my God.
So were you, like, turned on that like you got invited to Charlie Sheen's house? Because you had heard that he treats girls really well. Sometimes he'll pay him a whole bunch of dough.
Buy him cars and all that stuff.
And I guess you knew also that he had that dream of setting up a house where he gets, a 30,000-square-foot house.
I was a part of that whole spiel.
You were part of that, right?
Yeah.
So you were probably excited to be going to Charlie Sheen's house.
That deal was made within, the last couple of days. This wasn't, an ongoing, plan.
Right.
This plan came within the bench, and when he's serious and he wants something, all of his enablers are like, okay, we're gonna do whatever he says, because I'm like, what is he worth, like $380 million?
Isn't it exciting to go to a guy's house?
Isn't it wild that he has people who will just, oh, we gotta go find this porn star now.
Yeah. He's like, I want her. He wanted to see me a year ago, but then he's like, on the phone with him a year ago, and I didn't think he was actually gonna remember this. He's like, I want to see you. It was a mutual friend.
Yeah.
And then, 3 days later, he enters rehab. And I'm like, okay. So I'm like, okay, I'm never going to see this guy. Then he gets married and has, kids again. And I'm like, okay. And I'm just like, whatever. And then all of a sudden, I get this phone call.
Right.
Monday. Charlie wants to see you. So I show up, I'm like, okay.
Are you dressed really hot when you show up there?
Yeah, I'm like, okay, what am I going to wear? I'm like, okay, I'm going to look really slutty because I'm wearing this, sluts. So yeah. I put on my slutty's outfit.
What's your slutty's outfit?
I don't know, it's skirt, I don't know, it's this outfit I got in Miami, it's just hot.
Yeah, and so you go over, and there's a whole bunch of girls already there partying with him, right?
There's a bunch of random girls, but they all look like they're all run down, they've been with him for a long time, they were tired of his behavior, but I come in, and he's like, oh my God.
Right, you're
Casey.
Fresh meat. Yeah.
He's like, Casey, I can't believe it's you. He's like, do you remember that phone call from a year ago? I'm like, yeah. He's like, I have all your scenes memorized. If I'm saying this.
Right.
He's like, I'm going to tell you the scene from beginning to finish. I'm like, it's okay. I believe
you.
I don't even remember you. I don't even remember my scenes.
Right.
He's like, this is what happened. I'm like, okay. So I listen to one of my scenes. I'm like, okay.
And now you're already bored. When guys are high and you're not,
He wasn't even high. He was just drunk at this point.
Right.
Because they ran out of drugs from the night before. So now he's drunk again.
So he drinks every day probably and gets high every single fucking day. I mean, it's one nonstop party with this guy. Isn't it a miracle he's still alive?
I don't know how he was,
How does he function at work? I mean, how can he possibly go to work and clean up and do that TV show?
He doesn't clean up. He just does the TV show.
How does he do that? How does he memorize lines? He's so fucked up.
I have no idea.
He's like goddamn Superman.
He remembered her scene. Obviously, it's an incredible memory.
His eyes are halfway shut.
Uh-huh.
Wine stains all over him. All drunk. He's like... And I'm like, how is this guy functioning and getting details?
Right.
Details.
Yeah.
And that time when I first saw him, I first came over is when, we did the alcohol contest and who can drink more and don't do that with him. Don't know his guy.
So you have the drinking contest. You're hanging out with him. Are you dressed at this point? Or are you does he want you naked hanging out?
No, I'm dressed.
Right.
And all the other girls start to leave because one of the girls got pissed off when I showed up because he's like, he ignored all the rest of the girls.
Right, they can't just hang and let him have fun
with you. Casey's my favorite.
Are there any other guys or is it just Charlie and all these women?
It was just Charlie and his real estate agent who just signed for that $20 million house agreement where that guy leaves for Thailand and he's going to rent the house for $250 a month. We're all going to live in this house.
Charlie and another guy. And Charlie's smart though. He doesn't share the girls with anybody. He wants you to himself.
Yeah. There's another guy. The only guy that was there was Rick, his assistant.
So take me through the night because I got to understand this. You do the drinking contest thing. He, of course, beats you because he can beat anyone. And you're no lightweight, but nevertheless, he can beat you at a drinking contest. You get pretty high from drinking. And then there's no coke, but some guy comes over, I read, with a leather satchel. He has a whole bunch of coke.
Oh, my God.
It's like 20 grand worth of coke. Big fucking hunks of coke.
Like, like tennis ball size, like just like.
Like Scarface. He lives like Scarface.
That's what I said. I'm like, I feel like I was like in Scarface. He puts it on the table, and he like takes one. He like throws it, and he goes. He's like, here you go, have one. And you're like, I'm like, no thanks. Because I'm like, if I get pulled over, I'm going to jail for life. Just carrying one of these things. I'm like, why do you need, like, a lifetime supply of Coke? I'm like, obviously, he's just going to continue.
So, but the weird thing is, after he gets all wasted and shit with the Coke and the drinking, then you go down to the theater to watch porno.
Yeah.
But not your pornos.
If we're just, like, critiquing porno.
Are you bored out of your skull?
I just had my drink in my hand, and I just sat there and like, okay.
So you're sitting in the theater.
Mm-hmm. He's sitting there with his pipe.
Yeah, he's got you, who's ready to go and have fun.
Uh-huh.
But he puts on pornos, and he starts to give you a detailed explanation of porno. Like, he has the world's largest porno collection, you said.
Yeah.
He's an expert in porno.
Loves porn. Porn, alcohol, and cocaine. That's like his, like...
I mean, I watch porn. I could last for 5 minutes watching porn. It's like, there's a purpose to watching porn. I'm going to beat off and be done with it. I don't watch porn.
I was a little bored on the porn thing. I was trying to make the best at everything. I was drunk, and I'm like...
Were you making out with him or anything during it?
No, we were sitting, because it's like movie theater chairs. We were sitting next to each other. I ended up passing out. I ended up falling asleep, and he's like, hey, wake up. And I'm like, he comes over, he goes...
You know, well, the smoke in your
mouth. Yeah, I'm like, okay, I'm awake. Oh my, yeah.
What is the thing? Why can't people go to sleep when they're high? Why is that such a bad thing?
Why can't
Why can't you take a nap and then wake up and be refreshed? I mean,
I would think that, like, you know, if we're gonna live in this like party house, I'm like, oh my god.
All right. When did he tell you that whole plan?
That's the beginning of the night.
Yeah, his whole plan. He has a master plan.
He's like, you're a missing blonde. This is what we're gonna do. He's like, I got this girl Bentley. I don't know if it was his Bentley, and then he like said, here you go, you can have it.
Right.
And he's like, what do you want? I'm like, give me a Bentley.
Right.
And he's like, done. What else do you want? I'm like, well, the car's pretty nice. I'm pretty content with that. I'm like, he's like, okay, well, you'll be taken care of with money. Anything you ever want. If you want something, let me know. It'll be done within an hour.
So he's going to buy a house, and like Noah's Ark, he's going to load it up with a blonde, a brunette. He's going to have one of everything.
He's
going to
have like a Playboy mansion.
He's going to have a Playboy mansion, and you guys are going to live there. And whenever he wants to fuck you, you'll be there, but you'll be well compensated.
Yeah.
You'll have Bentleys, you'll have money. That's his game plan.
That was his game plan.
He's like a 13-year-old boy.
He signed it. That's why the real estate agent was there. He signed the agreement that night.
Wow. To rent this house.
Yeah.
Where is this house?
The house is on like 13100 Mulholland Estates.
That's
like,
the one he wants to buy.
Yeah, it's like from George Ballblatt. I don't know his last name.
Ballbuster? George Ballbuster?
Yeah.
So Charlie had this master plan to buy...
And he's already gotten the house. He's got the house.
What a fucking plan that is. That's some goddamn plan.
I was like, oh my, this one, like, okay, even though, like, I don't know if he's going to, like, really go through with this, but at that moment, I was like... I'm down because I'm like, I can drink every day. But then I didn't know he smoked the coke. I'm like, oh my god, imagine me living at this house. I'm probably going to OD like every other day.
Yeah, I mean, your drinking's out of control now. Imagine when you live in the house with the
and
drinking,
you
and you'll probably get hooked on coke.
Because
it's just going to happen. There's so much coke around it.
Oh my god.
Do you think he's out of control?
Yes.
You do?
Okay. I've never met anybody. Like, I mean, I've had my share. I mean, I'm an alcoholic, you know. I've seen, you know, my face, some of my family members, you know, I've never seen, it's like almost, even like a movie, like,
yeah.
Even, it's like worse than Scarface.
Wow.
Like, he could outdo Scarface times 10.
But wow. Do you admire him in some way? Like he's like the most,
he's
greatest drug taker, better than Keith Richards?
I just think it was attractive, you know, I knew he was like some bad boy, I'm like,
right.
You know, he's cool, I like guys, I like people who party and keep up with me.
Right.
But he was just like...
But he's too much for you.
It was too much. There's no way anybody... Charlie Sheen is the king. No one could outbeat him. Not anybody that I've...
Do you like him?
I like Charlie. I had fun.
When he takes his teeth... When you say his teeth are completely gone, is that gross?
Like, he had teeth, but they were gold. Mostly gold.
They're gold?
Gold.
How come we don't see that on TV, though? Like, how...
He must have, like, veneers or, you know, press-on teeth.
You mean, when you went in there, you just saw, like, gold teeth?
Like I said, it looked like Little John.
And the reason for that is because... the reason for the gold teeth is that they're easier to eat and stuff with because they stay in your head.
I don't know. It's like his teeth, like it was a whole... His whole tooth was gold. It wasn't, like...
Do you think that's from coke?
It's from drugs. I know it's from, like, his teeth falling out.
Is he still handsome? Or does he look really bad?
Well, when his teeth are out, I was like, oh, and the wine stain.
Take them out?